I am delighted to turn our attention now to the opening concert. Marin Alsop will lead the European Union Youth Orchestra together with the São Paulo Symphony Orchestra Choir and four exceptional soloists, Luisa Francesconi, Ao Lee, Eri Nakamura, and Tsvakalele Shabalala. They will perform two movements from Beethoven's Ninth Symphony, Ode to Joy. This performance marks the 250th year of the birth of Beethoven, and it is the start of Marin Alsop's Global Ode to Joy initiative, celebrating freedom, equality, and fraternity. The visuals that will accompany the performance are taken from the 9 beautiful paintings exhibited at the main entrance. These are by the late Nissan Engel and are his own interpretations of each of Beethoven's 9 symphonies. They were generously loaned to us by Mickey Engel, his wife, who is with us tonight. It is now my great pleasure to invite to the stage our partner and sponsor for this concert, the CEO of Intesa Sanpaolo, Mr. Carlo Messina, please.
So good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm very happy to be here. And thank you very much to you, Hilde and Klaus, to be in a position to be the sponsor for this 50th anniversary. And I can confirm you that we can be sponsor also for the next 50 years. So if you need a sponsor, you have also the possibility to have for the next 50 years. So we can join you in the next 50 years. In these items of the new World Economic Forum teams, so bringing together sustainability and inclusion, I think that Intesa Sanpaolo is absolutely a leader. We are a bank, we are generating profit for our shareholders, but we are also involved into creating conditions for community to have more possibility for inclusion. We are delivering and being the promoter for the most important project for poverty in my country, in Italy, and 9 million of Italians now have food thanks to Intesa Sanpaolo. We are also the promoter of a very important impact fund for the students in the country, 1 billion euros, and the mother that are working, and also involved in circular economy and green economy with 50 billion euros of new loans that we want to grant to the Italian companies in order to develop green economy. So that's the reason why I'm really happy to be the sponsor of this concert and again to stay with you in this occasion. So thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My deepest congratulations to this year's Crystal awardees. I feel truly humbled and honored to be counted among their ranks. My sincere thanks to Professor and Mrs. Schwab for inviting me back to celebrate this special 50th anniversary. 2020 is another special anniversary, especially for us. It marks the 250th anniversary of Beethoven's birth. With this year's forum theme of stakeholders for a sustainable and cohesive world, Beethoven's reverence for the natural world and his lifelong belief in the power of humankind to unite for positive change feels like the perfect synergy. Tonight, we're honored to bring you the Global Ode to Joy project, a project that will take place on six continents to reimagine Beethoven's iconic Ninth Symphony for our 21st century. In partnership with Carnegie Hall, the Global Ode to Joy has commissioned 9 new texts inspired by Schiller's and Beethoven's themes of unity, tolerance, peace, and joy. Our 120 performers this evening, in case you counted them, hail from 20 countries and range in age from 18 to 65. Please welcome first the young musicians of the European Union Youth Orchestra. And the wonderful singers from the São Paulo Symphony Choir. From Japan, soprano Eri Nakamura. And representing both Brazil and Italy, mezzo-soprano Luisa Francesconi. From Africa, tenors Wageli Chabalala. And from China, baritone Ao Li. We'd like to perform the Scherzo and the Finale from Beethoven's Ninth Symphony with a new text in Portuguese by Arthur Nestrovsky. We hope that Beethoven's profound belief in the goodness of humankind will offer inspiration as this 50th annual meeting of the forum begins. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. We'll be right back.